산업을 이해하고 기업을 이해해야 돈의 흐름이 보입니다. 리서치명가 메리츠증권과 3프로TV가 함께 야심차게 준비한 3프로TV 주식대학 겨울학기 실전투자특강. 남보다 한 발 앞서서 유망한 산업을 판단하고 1등 종목을 선정하는 투자의 기본기를 다지는 시간이 될 겁니다. 국내 최고의 애널리스트 21명과 함께 떠나는 2021년 성공투자를 위한 단 하나의 필수 코스. 지금 바로 신청하세요. 자세한 사항은 페이지 2 공지사항을 확인하세요.
안녕하세요.
You hear me?
Of course.
Hooray!
Hooray!
세계 3대 투자자라고 알려져 있고 또 한국에도 이미 굉장히 친숙해 있는 분입니다.
You see something. And when you see something that you know is going to succeed, you do your research and you buy the stock. That's how you become successful.
자, 3프로TV 시청자 여러분, 그리고 팟캐스트로 들으시는 경제신과 함께 청취자 여러분, 그리고 전국에 어쩌면 전 세계에서 저희 3프로TV를 보시는 투자자 여러분, 잘 지내셨죠? 오늘 지난번에 정말 저희가 야심찬 기획으로 우리 중앙일보 강남규 기자와 함께 선보였던 세계적인 석학들 또 쿠자이 구루들 이 줌으로 인터뷰하는 순서 두 번째 시간으로 여러분 인사드리게 됐습니다. 오늘 모셔야 될 분, 여러분 굉장히 기대 많이 하시는 분이죠. 세계 3대 투자자라고 알려져 있고 또 한국에도 이미 굉장히 친숙해 있는 분입니다. 로저스 홀딩스의 회장을 맡고 있는 짐 로저스를 오늘 화상으로 연결해 보겠습니다. 강 기자님.
네.
짐 로저스 뭐 많이 알려져 있지만.
그렇죠. 유명한 사람이죠.
우리 강 기자님께서 한번 소개를 한번 해 주시죠.
제가 개인적으로 기자로서 인터뷰는 지금 이게 세 번째인데요. 짐 로저스를. 그러니까 로저스하고 통화할 때마다 사실은 아주 기술적이고 어디다 구체적으로 어느 종목을 사야 되느냐라는 그런 질문보다는 예. 좀 더 큰 그림을 물어보곤 했습니다. 그런데 오늘만큼은.
우리 투자자들을 위해서.
예. 투자자들을 위해서. 너의 포트폴리오를 좀 열어볼 수 있도록 해달라 예. 라고 그 질문을 좀 던져볼 예정입니다.
예. 당황하시지 않을까요?
글쎄요. 기자는 원래 질문권 네. 무엇인지 물어볼 수 있는 권리를 갖고 있다고 스스로 잡아하니까 누가 주진 않았지만
우리 또 3프로 시청자 여러분들은 또 얼마나 좋겠어요.
아 예. 일단 뭐 로저스 같은 경우는 사실은 제가 오늘 뭐 많이 알려진 사람이기 때문에 간단하게 소개를 한다라면은 네. 옥스포드 영국의 옥스포드 대학에서 히스토리 역사를 전공했습니다. 그런데 네. 이 역사라는 걸 조금은 좀 눈여겨 봐야 될 대목인데요.
예.
월가의 중요한 금융 그룹의 경영자급 그러니까 VP급 바이스 프레지던트 이상 되는 사람들의 전공을 조사해 보면 놀랍게도 역사를 전공한 사람이 한 맞습니다. 4위 정도 됩니다.
예, 맞습니다.
예. 역사를 통해서 간접적으로 얻는 그 인사이트가 개별 종목을 시장을 읽고 개별 종목을 고르는데 상당히 도움이 됐지 않았을까.
네.
그 점도 시간 나면 한번 물어보겠습니다. 오늘.
Hello, Jim.
Can you hear me?
Of course.
Hooray!
Hooray!
많은 사람들이 짐을 3대 투자자라고 여기고 있습니다. 그런 어떤 세 평에 대해서 어떻게 스스로 생각하고 있는지 궁금합니다.
No, I'm just a simple person.
Simple person이란 말이 무슨 뜻일까요?
Well, I'm a simple person. I try to, you know, pay my bills. I try to have successes. I make many mistakes. But I try to do my research. I try to stay with what I know and I try to succeed. But sometimes I make mistakes, many mistakes.
리서치를 많이 하신다고 했는데 요즘 관심 갖는 연구는 어떤 겁니까?
Well, I try to find places where there is change taking place. I try to find things that are cheap, that are ignored, where there's positive change taking place. And sometimes if you do a lot of research, that will lead to opportunities and success. In my view, the Korean Peninsula will be a place like that. most people have ignored Korea for ever. For instance, Korea has never been on the international tourism map for many reasons, reasons for centuries. In my view, that is going to change in the future. And some parts of Korea are extremely cheap because of history. And when the 38th parallel opens, the Korean Peninsula is going to be perhaps the most exciting place in the world for 10 or 20 years for many reasons. I mean, listen, there are people who go to Korea. People know where Korea is. I'm not saying nobody ever heard of it, but very, very few people. It has not been on the tourism map, especially North Korea, and that's going to change, if you ask me, and that will lead to many opportunities. Disaster and opportunity are the same thing. As recently as 1970, North Korea was richer than South Korea. But yeah, the Kims and communism ruined everything. Well, the Kims and the communists ruined North Korea. But that might lead to an opportunity. There is a word in Chinese, Japanese, and Korean. In Chinese, it's a weiji. In Japanese, it's kiki. I forget the word in Korean. It's the same character. By the way, it's the same character in all three languages. But it means that opportunity and disaster are the same thing. So I'm always looking for things where there might be opportunities.
Jim, 요즘 어떤 자산 배분을 하고 계시고요? 포트폴리오도 뭐 이 기회에 살짝 좀 소개해 주시면 좋겠습니다.
I don't think I will bother telling you things I bought 20 years ago or 25 years ago that I still own. You don't care about, you shouldn't care about that. You should care what I'm doing now. Well, what I'm doing now, what I have been doing, the Japanese stock market is down 30 or 40% from its all-time high. The Bank of Japan goes to work every day, prints money, and buys stocks, bonds, and ETFs. Well, if the Bank of Japan is buying ETFs, I want to buy ETFs. Yes. They have more money than I do. The market's depressed. The American market's making all-time highs. But in Japan, it's down. And the guy's printing a lot of buying ETFs. If he's going to buy ETFs, I want to buy ETFs. Now, Japan has huge problems long term. But I'm talking about now. I'm not talking about long term. Russia. Russia's hated. But some shares in Russia are very cheap. I bought a Russian shipping company recently. Very, very depressed, very cheap. I bought wine companies in China. You know, the virus has caused people to stop going out. Anything to do with the tourism, transportation, entertainment, very depressed in many parts of the world. I would suspect that we're going to go to restaurants again. I would suspect we're going to go to bars again. So I bought Chinese wine companies. These are some of the things that I have been doing. I hope that these are opportunities. I have been buying agriculture. Agriculture is very depressed these days, extremely depressed, and has been depressed for a long, long time. Maybe we're never going to eat again. Maybe we're never going to wear clothes again. But in the meantime, I mean, I'm buying agriculture and some other commodities. I mean, things like, you know, silver. Silver is down 50% from its all-time high. Sugar is down 80% from its all-time high. The American stock market is at all-time highs. I had rather find things that are not high. I'd rather find things that are low and invest there.
그래서 아주 흥미로운 얘기를 했는데 다른 인터뷰하고 달리 굉장히 구체적으로 상품 가운데 특히 중국의 포도주 회사 와인 컴퍼니 그다음에 은 가격 그다음에 러시아의 자산 러시아의 주식 기타 등등에서 의미 있는 얘기를 했습니다.
자, 우리가 사실 짐 로저스 그러면 원자재 시장에 매우 뛰어난 투자자로 기억을 하고 있는데요. 조금 더 구체적으로 원유라든지 금 혹은 은 구리 등 요즘에 이 메탈 혹은 커머디티 어떻게 보고 계시는지 좀 여쭤보겠습니다.
As I look around the world, bonds all over the world are in a bubble. They are certainly not cheap. They've never been this expensive in history. Many stock markets are very expensive. Property in many places is very, very expensive. Seoul, other cities, but property is very expensive. So the cheapest asset class I see are commodities. As I said, sugar's down 80%, silver's down 50%. So commodities are cheap on a historic basis. Doesn't mean they will go up, but they're certainly cheap. So I am not buying silver and gold now. I stopped buying silver and gold a few weeks ago, but when they go down some more, I will buy more gold, I will buy more silver, especially silver, since silver's cheaper on a historic basis. I will buy more agriculture, I'll buy more probably of all commodities. All right. Copper is now making the highest it's been in 7 years, because now there's a huge move for electric cars. I don't know if electric cars will happen, but I know if they do, they require a lot of copper, a huge amount of copper. An electric car takes several times as much copper as a normal car. So there may be opportunities in commodities in the future.
커머디티의 어떤 포트폴리오에 대해서 굉장히 그 설명을 잘 해주셨는데 굉장히 중요한 이슈죠. 환율에 대해서 특히 달러에 대해서 한번 질문을 해주시죠.
이제는 좀 달러에 대해서 미국의 달러에 대해서 여쭤보겠습니다. 이 달러 가치 요즘 자꾸 떨어지는데 어떻습니까? 달러의 미래가?
Well, the United States is the largest debtor nation in the history of the world. And the debts are going higher and higher every day. So the U.S. dollar has serious problems in the future. But I own a lot of U.S. dollars now. You will probably say, why? Why? I own it because when there is turmoil, people look for a safe haven. They think the U.S. dollar is a safe haven. For historic reasons. And so I own the U.S. dollar is going to get overpriced in the next turmoil, might even turn into a bubble. At that time, I will have to sell my U.S. dollars and put the money somewhere else. I do not know where. I do know that many countries are now working on a competitor for the U.S. dollar. China, Russia, India, Brazil, other countries are trying to find a competitor for the U.S. dollar because for economic reasons, the world needs a new currency. And for political reasons, the world needs a new currency. I don't know what and when, but I know the U.S. dollar will lose its status in the future.
예, 지금 달러 인덱스가 90레벨인데요. 두세 달 동안 굉장히 많이 빠졌습니다. 신흥국 자산, 특별히 이 신흥국의 주식시장에 달러 인덱스가 굉장히 중요하다고 우리가 알고 있는데요. 어떻게 보세요? 달러 인덱스가 앞으로도 계속 떨어질 거로 보시는지요?
I own a lot of U.S. dollars. It went up a lot. It's having a correction. Nothing goes straight up or straight down. It is normal. This is the way markets work. You must watch e-broadcast. You must know that. Markets have corrections all the time.
All right.
U.S. dollars having a correction, a normal correction. I explained it's going to go much higher in the turmoil. It will get overpriced. It will might turn into a bubble. I don't know how much lower the correction is going to go. I know that there are many, many people pessimistic about the dollar now. That usually leads to a rally. But I don't know what's going to happen. I know that what's happening in markets so far has been normal. And the way markets, from what I know of markets, normal and the way things work. I mean, you can watch Sampro TV, ask them. But I don't see anything unusual here.
All right.
Yet.
달러가 강세로 전환할 수도 있다는 얘기는 주가가 조정받을 수 있다는 얘기로 들리는데요. 네. 그렇다면 버블일 수도 있다는 얘기도 들립니다.
Some bubbles are developing in things like the FANGs, which are, you know, there's some stocks in America, internet stocks that go up every day, are very expensive. obviously a bubble is forming there. Alibaba, Tencent, some stocks in China. So yes, we do have bubbles beginning to develop, but I don't see any market that is a complete bubble yet. You know, in a real bubble, everything goes up every day. That bubbles have may have started, but I don't see a total bubble yet in stock markets anywhere yet. Some sectors, yes, but that could go on for a while.
3프로 TV의 그 100만 시청자들을 대신해서 질문을 좀 드려보겠습니다. 한국 주 시장은 어떻게 보시고요? 지금 현재 사상 최고가를 치고 있는데 어떻게 좀 위험해 보이시나요?
Well, it's like some other stock markets. The U.S. stock markets are at an all-time high too, but many stocks are down. Many stocks in 2020 are actually down this year. The same is true in Korea. Your averages are at all-time high or near making highs, but many stocks are not. So when you ask me about the market, the stock market is a market of stocks. If you pick the right stocks at the right time, you will probably make a lot of money. But like in the U.S., Amazon goes up every day and goes up a lot, and it's very expensive. So the averages are high. But if you find, I mean, some stocks in Korea are down a lot this year. So if you find the right stocks in any market, you might make money.
Jim, 예를 들어 한국 주식 가운데 어떤 주식을 사고 싶어요?
I mean, I own shares of Korean Airline, for instance. I bought more recently. That's down a lot. People stop traveling. Not just, I mean, airlines in other countries do. People stop traveling. If you go to the airport in Singapore, it's empty. Someday people are going to fly to London again. Someday people are going to fly to New York again. They're not going to take the boat. And so maybe there are opportunities in airlines in some parts of the world.
네, 금융시장에서 미국 얘기로 좀 주제를 바꿔보겠습니다. 바이든 정부가 이제 출범을 하는데 경제정책을 어떻게 평가하시는지요? 그리고 한국 같은 신흥국 주식시장에는 바이든 행정부의 출범이 어떤 영향을 줄 거로 보시는지요?
Mr. Biden, if he's the next president and the people around him all think you can print money and spend money and borrow money, and that's what they will do. They have a long history of showing that that's how they think. Doesn't matter what I think, that's what they think, and that's what they will do. And so printing money is usually good for markets, at least for a while. Spending money is usually good for markets, at least for a while. The U.S. market has been going up for years, and it's not expensive now. I told you a bubble is starting to develop in the U.S., and so this will, and I told you it's not over yet. So this will probably continue the development of the bubble. But all bubbles break, all bubbles end someday. So I would suspect that later next year or the year after, it will come to an end. It's been, the American stock market has been going up the longest in American history.
Right.
So, and some stocks are getting very, very expensive. But I don't see that it will stop now because Mr. Biden loves to spend money.
예전에 트럼프가 대통령에 당선될 것으로 예상을 했는데 예상이 어긋났습니다.
That's all I said was that history shows it's very difficult to unseat a sitting president. It has happened, and it looks like it may have happened again in 2020. Mr. Trump says he's still president. Mr. Trump says he will be the next president. I have no idea. I know the indications are Mr. Biden will be the president next year. I don't know. If you know the answer, you can make a lot of money. Mr. Trump says he's still the president. Everything I know says that Mr. Biden's the next president, but I don't know. But I do know that history shows it's hard to get rid of a sitting president. It has happened, and it may have happened in 2020. Yes.
굉장히 그 특이한 결과가 나왔다고 하셨는데 왜 그럼 이런 특이한 결과가 이번 선거에서 나왔다고 보시는지요?
Well, It has happened a few times in American history. It's always mm-hmm. been because of something unusual happening.
Yes.
In 1980, it was because of a crisis in Iran, and we changed. This time, we've certainly had the virus, the virus crisis, a crisis mm-hmm. caused by the virus. So, when it has happened in the past, it's been because of something unusual happening. I'm sure you know that 2020 was an unusual year because we had a worldwide virus and many countries closed down. So that was a very unusual event, and it may have led to the end for Mr. Trump.
바이든의 대북 정책은 어떨까요?
I know that everybody in China and Russia and North Korea and many people in South Korea wants this to end. Japan is against it because Japan cannot compete with an open Korea, and they know it. Japan has very serious problems, and they know that if Korea opens, they will have a serious competitor. But they cannot stop. They're trying to stop it, but there's very little they can do. The main problem is the American Army. The American Army does not want to leave. It's the only place in the world that American can have troops on the Chinese border and the Russian border. Now, if I were Korea, I wouldn't want that. That means if there's a war, you're in the war, but the American Army does not want to leave. That's the problem. I thought Mr. Trump and Mr. Moon would be tough enough to throw them out. They weren't. Since things have started opening, maybe Mr. Biden will take a new approach. If America keeps saying to South Korea, you must pay, you must pay, you must pay for us to occupy you, maybe the South Koreans will say, get out of here. We've been here 5,000 years. We've had some good times and we've had some bad times, and we can take care of ourselves. We do not need to be occupied by a foreign army after 70 years. So I don't know. I would suspect that they will start talks again on this subject. Mr. Biden and his people are not as open-minded because, you know, he's been down there 47 years. I mean, he thinks like Washington, but maybe he will start thinking a little different and things will open and maybe something will finally happen. You have an election coming. Maybe your people will also start to ask questions. It's 70 years. You've been occupied by the American Army for 70 years. In history, that is not normal. So I would think that things will open up, and I would expect something to happen in the next few years. But you should ask Seoul. You're there.
네, 한국에 대해서 로저스 씨 질문 있으면 저희한테 해주시면 저희가 답변해 드리겠습니다.
I don't have to ask. Just watch Sampro TV.
Okay. All right.
이게 이번에 새로 나온 새 책인 것 같은데요. 어떤 내용을 담으셨습니까?
Japan is in decline. Japan has very serious problems. Japan has population declining for 10 years. Debt going up every day, higher and higher for 10 years. So if you're 10 years old in Japan, you have no future. You should leave. You should leave Japan, or you should learn to use a gun, because there's going to be problems when you're 40 or 50 or 60. At the same time, I wrote about the fact that Korea is now on the rise. Korea, but mainly because when the 38th parallel opens, North Korea has a lot of cheap, educated, disciplined labor with lots of natural resources. South Korea has huge capital ability, manufacturing ability. South Korea knows how to run an economy. So you will have cheap, disciplined labor with lots of natural resources, 80 million people on the Chinese border. So Japan is peaked and going into decline. which is very important for the world, and Korea is on the rise. I told you, Korea has not been on the tourism map ever in history, for instance. That's going to change. Other positive change is taking place on Hanbando, the Korean peninsula. So there are huge changes taking place in Asia, especially with two very important countries, Korea and China and Japan. And so we're going to see differences. And also going to see huge problems in the world. America's got huge debts. Everybody does. In 2008, we had a problem because of too much debt. Oh, since 2008, the debt everywhere has skyrocketed. Even China has a lot of debt now. So there are huge, huge changes taking place. And you should be aware. You should be aware of them. If you know what's going on, you will be prepared and you will do well.
조 바이든 행정부가 중국을 견제하기 위해 북한을 조커로 쓸 수 있다라고 하는 사람들이 전문가들이 좀 있습니다. 어떻게 생각하는지요?
Well, I guess he could, but I don't see why he would. I don't know why. Yeah, of course. I mean, in Washington now, because of Trump, there's been a lot of anti-Chinese talk. When things go wrong in any country, any time in history, they blame foreigners. It's very easy to blame foreigners. They have different skin, different language, different food, different clothes, different everything. Easy to blame foreigners. And politicians always do throughout the world. So Washington has been blaming foreigners and mainly China, but they blame Korea, Japan, Mexico, everybody, but especially China for many reasons. So yes, the new guys have been blaming China, but usually after the election, that would calm down. Now, I guess the problem is North Korea is not much of a threat to anybody, and certainly not to China. I guess Mr. Biden could try to do something like that, but it doesn't make sense, but why not? I mean, you know, politicians in America do strange things. Maybe Mr. Biden will try to say to North Korea, okay, let's attack China. Doesn't make sense, but maybe he will try to use North Korea against China. I don't think that will work. I told you that the American army does not want to leave, but it's the only place they can have troops on the Chinese border. It's an interesting thought, but I doubt it. I don't see that it would work. I don't think it would work.
네, 최근에 한국신문의 인터뷰 기사를 제가 몇 개 봤는데요. 짐이 한국의 젊은 투자자들, 특별히 이번에 새로 주식시장에 참여한 동학개미들 이거 굉장히 걱정된다고 하셨더라고요. 왜 그런 생각을 하셨고요? 그렇다면 이분들에게 좀 조언을 이번 기회에 좀 주시면 좋겠습니다. 어떤 조언 주시겠습니까?
Don't you? I mean, I see what's happening. Yes, I mean, I read the same newspapers you do. You probably know better than I do that there is, not just in Korea, but in America and other places too now.
Right.
You know, many people are jumping into the stock market. They've never invested in stocks before. They don't know much about it. Mm-hmm. And they buy and hope. And they buy and it goes up because everything they buy, Apple, Samsung, whatever they buy these days is going up. So they think this is easy. Mm-hmm. This is fun, and this is wonderful. Mm-hmm. They tell their friends, and then their friends do the same thing. Mm-hmm. So, no, I mean, this has happened many times in history, as you know. We've had bubbles develop. I said to you before, I can see the beginnings of bubbles in some stock markets, in some sectors, it's not the first time I've seen this. It's not the first time in history it's happened, and it's happening again. It usually is the beginning of a bubble. It usually leads to a bubble. Eventually, everybody's doing it. Eventually, everybody is watching Sampro TV. They want to invest. But then it it gets it turns into a bubble, and all bubbles end badly. If you want to be a successful investor, you don't listen to me. You don't listen to your friends. You only invest in what you yourself know a lot about. Mm-hmm. Everybody watching this knows a lot about something. Cars, fashion, something. Mm-hmm. You stay with what you know. You know, you will see when something is changing that is going to be successful long before I will. You go on the internet and the TV every day and you look at what you love. So you will see something. And when you see something that you know is going to succeed, you do your research and you buy the stock. Mm. That's how you become successful. Mm. If I told you you can only have 20 investments in your life, you would be careful. You wouldn't jump around. You wouldn't jump in and out. You wouldn't listen to hot tips. You would be successful. It's boring, boring, boring. Nobody wants, no, everybody wants, I want a hot tip, hot tip, hot tip. Well, everybody wants to be rich this week. I will tell you, hot tips will make you lose all your money. If you want to be successful, stay with what you know, only with what you know, and you will be successful.
워낙에 이제 짐 로저스가 경험도 많은 투자자고요. 또 많은 위기를 경험하셨는데 경제 위기의 사인, 시그널은 어떤 징후, 어떻게 판단하시는지 좀 아이디어가 있으면 좀 공유해 주실까요?
I explained to you before about bubbles. I can see a bubble developing in some countries now. If it continues to develop, things will go higher. It'll be more and more exuberance. Everything will go up. Everything will get overpriced. And then something will happen. I don't know what. The central banks will change their mind. War. Bankrupt. Somebody will go bankrupt. Somebody made big will go bankrupt. There's always something that happens to cause things to come to an end. I don't know. What I expect is, the main problem now is the American Central Bank. The American Central Bank is printing and will continue to print. All of them will, but especially America, and America is the most important now. So they will continue to print and borrow and spend, and that will lead to more problems eventually. But then somewhere along the line, people are going to say, I don't care. I'm not going to do this anymore. But I hope that I can recognize. I'm sure I will be early. My timing is always bad. I hope I'm smarter. I'd rather get out early, though, than late. Mm-hmm. But once the bubble pops, it's very difficult. But I hope that I will recognize, you know, when people, everybody you know, when you know people who are leaving their jobs to go into the stock market. When you go to the doctor and the receptionist wants to talk to you about the stock market, you know, when they all want to talk to about the stock market, then you know it's coming to an end.
바로 지금이네요.
Now, well, I know, I told you, I can see bubble. No, there are many signs that the bubble is developing. Maybe today. I don't know. I don't. It may be ending today, but it seems to me that because the new government in America will borrow and spend more money and print more money, they want things to go up. Yes, we may have a correction for a while. November was one of the strongest markets in history. Maybe we'll have a correction. If we have a correction, it will be good because then the governments will try to do things to get the market up again. And if they get it up again, I told you, we may well have a bubble next year, but bubbles always end badly.
지금까지 오랜 기간 투자자로 지내왔는데 일생에서 가장 큰 실수를 좀 소개해 주실 수 있겠습니까?
I make many mistakes. You want to hear about my first wife? You want to hear about my first wife?
Already.
No, I'll tell you again. It was a huge mistake. Oh, wow. You know, early in my career, I had a huge triumph. Everybody was going broke and I was tripling my money. And I thought I was smart. So I turned around, I reversed my position the very day, waited a few months, sold short, lost everything. You know, and 2 or 3 months after that, I lost everything. I was not unhappy. I was not happy. I went from being a genius, I thought, to losing everything in a short period of time. But that's, you know, I make many mistakes. Many mistakes.
그럼 가장 성공적인 투자는 뭐였습니까?
Oh, my greatest success. I have two girls now. I never I never wanted to have children. I thought children were a terrible waste of time and money and energy. I was never going to have children. Well, I was wrong. I was wrong. I had my first child when I was 60. If there's anybody watching this who has not had children, please have children. Do it for yourself, do it for Korea, do it for the world.
딸들이 그 BTS에 굉장히 열광한다는 얘기가 있더라고요.
They love K-pop, they love K-drama, they love Korea, yes.
Okay. All right.
매우 감사합니다. 다음 인터뷰도 기대하겠습니다.
Okay, whatever you want, but in the meantime, please watch e-broadcasting.
네, 고맙습니다. 짐. 감사합니다.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
여러분 어떻게 보셨습니까? 이 사실 짐 로저스가 유독 한국 그 매체와 인터뷰를 많이 한 것처럼 보이지만요. 이렇게 어떤 의미에서 굉장히 진솔하고 구체적으로 한 시간 인터뷰를 한 것도 사실 드문 일인 것 같습니다. 공중파에서 인터뷰라는 게 대부분 굉장히 큰 편집을 통해서 정말 필요한 것만 썼던 것 같은데 오늘은 아마 여러분들께서 지난번에 본 짐 로저스하고 또 다른 측면의 마음씨 좋은 아저씨 같은 그런 짐 로저스를 본 것 같은데 글쎄요. 뭐 이 짐 로저스의 투자 인생에 굉장히 의미 있는 성공과 실패 그런 얘기 끝에 아이를 가진 게 가장 큰 성공지 Great Investment라는 그 얘기를 저는 굉장히 가슴에 기억하고 싶은 그런 말씀인 것 같아요. 특히 젊은 분들에게 그 메시지는 굉장히 의미심장한 얘기가 아닌가 그런 생각도 해보게 됐습니다. 두 번에 걸쳐서 저희가 세계적인 석학 그리고 투자자들을 모셨습니다만은 지금은 조금 미숙하고 조금은 부자연스러운 인터뷰지만 해를 거듭할수록 우리 강남규 기자의 이 글로벌 네트워크를 활용하고 또 3프로TV 여러분들이 사랑해 주시면 정말 좋은 인터뷰를 저희가 계속해 나갈 수 있는 가능성을 본 인터뷰 아닌가 그렇게 생각합니다. 어떻게 보셨어요?
지금 사실 짐 로저스하고 아까 얘기했다시피 이번에 개인적으로는 세 번째 인터뷰인데요. 가장 구체적이고 가장 솔직하고 역시 그 어떤 오랜 기간 투자의 세계에서 머물렀던 사람이 많이 보여줄 수 있는 네. 그런 유머가 아주 감칠맛 나게 이번 인터뷰를
특히 이 브로드캐스팅을 3프로TV를 꼭 보라는 얘기
근데 왜 중앙일보는 언급하지 않았을까요?
중앙데일리는 모르더라고요.
아 글쎄 말이에요. 근데 참고로 말씀드리지만은 단독으로 인터뷰했을 때 늘 중앙일보에 물어보라고 얘기를 합니다. 그러니까 네. 행복했습니다. 네. 감사합니다. 네,
지난번에 어색했던 관계는 이제 완전히 회복된 그렇죠? 걸로 생각하셔도 될 것 같습니다. 자 지금까지 저 김프로였고요.
강남규였습니다.
네 다음 시간에 또 뵙겠습니다. 고맙습니다.